Dear students, now we are going to discuss about Poisson's equation and Laplace equation.
The scientist Poisson derived one equation which relates electric potential to charge density. That is, the potential of a conductor is directly proportional to the charge it contains. So this equation is called as Poisson equation. That is del squared V is equal to minus rho V divided by epsilon. Here V is the electric potential, rho V is the volume charge density, epsilon is the dielectric constant. Now we are going to prove this concept. Okay, so that is what here we have to consider two important concepts. The first one is the relation between electric potential and field intensity. This is what the direct relationship between electric field intensity and potential. E is equal to minus gradient of electric potential minus del V. So we can consider this as the first equation, and next consider electric gauss law in point form. What is electric gauss law? The divergence of electric flux density is equal to the total volume charge density. That is what electric gauss law. We have to consider this equation as the second one. So these two equations are very important to relate the potential and this volume charge density. So in that second equation, del dot D is equal to rho V. This D can be replaced as epsilon into E, as we know that D is equal to epsilon into E. So here I can take this epsilon outside since it is a constant. So epsilon into del dot E is equal to rho V. Next step, I can move this epsilon to the right hand side. So now it becomes del dot E is equal to rho V by epsilon. We can consider this as the third equation. So now we are going to substitute that first equation. What is the first equation? E is equal to minus del V. We are going to substitute this first equation in this third equation. So in this third equation, E can be replaced by this minus del V. So here this equation, third equation, becomes del dot E is replaced by minus del V. So minus del V is equal to rho V by epsilon. I can take this minus outside. So next, del dot del V is equal to rho V by epsilon. So del dot del is nothing but del square V is equal to this minus, we can move to this right hand side. So this will become del square V is equal to minus rho V by epsilon. So this is called as Poisson equation, which relates that potential to its volume charge density. So the same, this is the generalized form of Poisson equation, correct? Del square V is equal to minus rho V by epsilon. So in case of 3D coordinate representation, we can represent the same like this. In case of Cartesian coordinate system, Cartesian coordinate system means X, Y, Z. So three coordinates are X, Y, Z. We can represent the same del squared V is equal to minus rho V by epsilon as this del squared V becomes dou squared V by dou X squared plus dou squared V by dou Y squared plus dou squared V by dou Z squared is equal to minus rho V by epsilon, because this del squared can be written like this. This can be written as dou x of, that is del squared V can be written as dou by dou V by dou x plus dou by dou y of dou V by dou y plus dou by dou z of dou V by dou z. So this can be written like this, dou squared V by dou x squared, dou squared V by dou y squared, dou squared V by dou z squared. In a Cartesian coordinate system. Okay, so for cylindrical coordinate system, the same procedure can be followed. Here del squared V is equal to 1 by rho dou by dou rho into rho dou V by dou rho. plus 1 by rho squared dou squared v by dou phi squared plus dou squared v by dou z squared is equal to minus rho v by epsilon. Here in cylindrical coordinate system, the coordinates are rho phi z. The same principle can be followed over here. This is what del squared v means. First we have to find out the gradient of the v in terms of rho phi z, and then again take the divergence of that value. Okay. So next, spherical coordinate system. So its coordinates are r theta phi. So the terms can be written like this. Del squared v is equal to 1 by r squared dou by dou r into r squared dou v by dou r plus 1 by r squared sin theta, since it is a angle. Okay. So 1 by r squared sin theta dou by dou theta sin theta dou v by dou theta plus 1 by r squared sin squared theta plus dot dou squared v by dou phi squared. Okay, these two are the angles. That's why we can multiply this term with this term 1 by r squared sin squared theta. That is equal to minus rho v into epsilon. Okay, so these three are the different 3D coordinate systems to express the Poisson equation. Next one is Laplace equation. So in this Laplace equation, if an enclosed surface does not have any volume charge density, then the Poisson equation, the same Poisson equation, becomes del squared v is equal to 0. The condition for this Laplace transform is, consider one enclosed surface. This is the enclosed surface. In this surface, suppose it does not have any volume charge density. It does not have volume charge density means that rho v is equal to 0. Correct. We know that Poisson equation is what? Del squared v is equal to minus rho v by epsilon. Correct. So if rho v is equal to 0 means the right hand side fully 0. So del squared v is equal to 0. This is called Laplace equation. So here del squared is called as Laplacian operator. So where we are using this Laplace equation? The solutions of this Laplace equations are the harmonic functions generally. This kind of harmonic functions are very, very important in partial differential equation, physics and engineering field, especially at the boundary conditions. Whenever there is a boundary conditions there, we have to implement this harmonic functions. The applications of Laplace equation is given like this. It is used in boundary value problems. In that case, the charge distribution is involved on the surface of the conductor for which the volume charge density is 0. So here the charge distribution is involved on the surface. That is very, very important. Charge distribution involved on the surface, not inside this. So this is the closed surface, correct? It is the closed volume or closed surface. Here we can say it is a closed volume where there is no charge density. In this case, we are having the charge distribution only on the surface. Inside that volume, there is no charge. So in such case, we can use this Laplace equation to obtain potential and capacitance in between two surfaces. Okay, the best example, we can say this Laplace equation is widely used to find out the potential between the conductors of the coaxial cable. So in this case, consider this is a coaxial cable, inner conductor and outer conductor. In between, there is no charge. Correct. This is the inner conductor. This is the outer conductor. Okay. So in between these two, if there is no charge, volume charge density. Okay. So we are having charge distribution only on that surface. In that case, we are going to find out the potential using this del squared V is equal to 0. Correct. So by solving this equation for this coaxial cable, we come to know the value of this voltage. If we know the value of this voltage, we can easily get the capacitance value by using the formula Q by V. So once we find the value of V, we can obtain the value of capacitance. So this is the best example for this Laplace equation.